Before talking about the Bitcoin risk analysis in Python, that is the maximum drawdown, I have an interesting question for you. Do you consider worst case scenario analysis before making any decisions? You'll say yes, of course. Like in our personal lives, we just always do it. But in investing life, let me just give an example to you. Suppose today is an amazing day and you plan to do skydiving, right? So what will be the first thing that will come to your mind before boarding the plane? You'll check the bag in which the parachute is there. You'll check the rope through which the parachute is connected, and you'll see whether it operates perfectly or not, right? This is the worst case scenario. Otherwise, what will happen? You'll board the plane, it will go over the mountains, and then you'll jump out. Slowly, you'll come down, and then the parachute will not open. You'll come down and you'll die. That's the worst case scenario. So guys, note it down somewhere. Investing life is also similar to skydiving, especially if you are investing or trading in securities like cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin. In this video, we'll talk about the maximum drawdown, which is the worst case scenario in the world of investing slash trading. And it will have a caliber to convert your negative 20% or even more negative number to a positive number, right? So are you ready? Dude, I forgot something. My beatbox. Yeah, 3, 2, 1, go. Hello everyone, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. In this video, we'll talk about one of the most important risk measures, which is maximum drawdown. And we'll build a Python model on maximum drawdown to see how risky Bitcoin is. And then we'll also see that we'll have to make a trading strategy such that this worst case scenario analysis is being incorporated in our trading analysis and such that we don't suffer through this big shock in our investing life. But before that, if you're new around here, on this channel, I turn you into a successful financial programmer. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, backtesting, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, etc., etc. So if this is something you're interested in, smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, there's an amazing gift to all my lovely subscribers. What is this gift? You'll very soon get to know about that. So without any further ado, let's start. So maximum drawdown is a measure which is used to measure the amount of bleeding or loss that an investor could have experienced if he had bought at the last peak and sold at the subsequent trough, like this one. So you buy it here and sell it here. You're that unlucky person. So this is the maximum drawdown is actually the loss that you will make when you buy here and sell here. Now, as I mentioned before, that it is a very important risk parameter, right? But whenever you heard about the word risk, you think of volatility, right? Standard deviation. But if you think wisely, then the volatility is not actually a bad thing, right? Because like, what's it? Remember, it's just a deviation from the mean, right? And if you imagine that if you deviate from the mean in the upside direction, then volatility is a good thing, right? So few people think that risk is basically the possibility of losing money. It should not be equivalent to volatility. So for example, I have money, I lost it, so that's a risk. And this is exactly what maximum drawdown is trying to cover here. If you remember a few weeks back, I made a Bitcoin day trading bot, right? Using engulfing and Arun technical indicator. So we can actually do backtesting using maximum drawdown. It can be one of the parameter for backtesting. If you're interested to watch how I made that trading strategy, you just click on this I button to watch those video. So let's start our Python code. As I mentioned, I will be extracting the Bitcoin prices, historical prices, to do this analysis. To make it more interactive, I will have the interval of 5 minutes. And then do this analysis. If you are watching this video after watching my backtesting playlist, then yes, you can add this as one of the parameter for backtesting. If you have not watched that playlist, you can click on this I button to watch that playlist. And it was about backtesting my trading strategy on the Bitcoin day trading bot that I made. So this is one of the parameter that we can add in the risk analysis. If you remember, I did value at risk analysis in that. So yeah, this is the second one. So let's start with all the libraries that we need. Starting from import pandas spd requests, what else, numpy as np, date time as dt, and let's take the warnings as well. So warnings dot filter warnings, and then just ignore because there were some there are some warnings that I don't want to see, because those are not errors actually. So yeah, so yeah, for this analysis I'm going to use a 12 data API. This is the 12 data API key. What is 12 data? 12 data is a data provider which is actually free, and we can get historical cryptocurrency and other stock data and a lot of things through 12 data API. I have covered a very detailed video on 12 data. If you're interested to know more things about this amazing data provider, then you can click on this I button, and all the links will be in the description box as well. So you can just go ahead with that. But in this one, I'm actually referring to this API key, which I will be changing after recording this video for sure, because I want you to have your own API key. So yeah, the symbol is BTC USD, which is Bitcoin and USD. Interval is, as I mentioned, it will be 5 minutes, and order is ascending. So let's take the date, end date, to be yesterday, right? So dt.datetime, and then yesterday was 14th, so 2021 July, and then 14, right? And then start date, let's go 15 days back, right? So we'll have this 15 days of historical data for cryptocurrency for all 5 minutes interval, right? It will be a lot of data, actually close to 5000 rows. So end date minus dt.time delta, and then days is equal to 15. Right. This is the API URL of 12 data. Again, if you want to know this thing in detail, then you can watch that video, 12 data video. But yeah, anyways, like basically this is the API, the URL from which we are extracting all the data. So I'll briefly explain what it is. So this is the URL for, I would say, base URL. And then we are putting symbol as symbol. This is one. The start date is start date, end date is end date that we actually introduced already. Interval is 5 minutes, which is here. And then order is ascending, and then API key is equal to API key. So everything is here. Using this, we will be able to extract all the information from 12 data for free. Now, basically, we'll just use the requests library to extract all this information. So request.get and then API URL.json. So we'll get everything in the JSON format. Let's see what is date now, data now. Perfect. So we have got this JSON output, and if I write keys, so we have meta, values, and status. I'm only interested in values. I'll just go here and then paste values here and convert it into pandas data frame. So data final is equal to pd dot data frame, like this. So let's see what's the data now. So the data final is it's just a little bit more than 4000 rows, and you can see that entire data is actually 5 minutes interval data of Bitcoin of last 15 days, right? So we have open, high, close, and low. Actually, the thing is, for some reason, if you go to the close, you can see that this is actually type, the data type is object. We'll have to convert it into float format, otherwise we'll not able to do the calculation. So data close is equal to pd dot to numeric, and then data final close, and then error is this. Also, let's make the date time to be the index. So data final dot set index, and then date time in place is equal to true. Let's see what is the final data frame that we have. So yeah, you can see that the date time is the index right now, and we have all this columns in front of you. I'm actually only interested in close, that's why I just converted close into the float format. So if you go here, click like this, you can see that this is into this has been converted into the float format. Now, if you remember this image, there is always a window to do this maximum drawdown analysis. For example, in this one, this is the window. So there has to be a certain number of days in which we will do this analysis, and we'll see what was the peak and what was the trough at that in that particular window, and then eventually we'll do the analysis. So I'm interested in 24 hours. So because this 5 minutes interval, how many intervals will be there, how many rows will be there for 24 hours? So it's basically there are 24 hours in a day, and then how many five intervals in 1 hour? 12. So it's 288. So I'll have to provide window to be 288. So window is equal to 288. Basically, there are 288 5 minute intervals in 1 day. That's what I'm interested in. And my window will actually shift with time. And this window will actually cover the last 24 hours. That's the main idea. Now, if you have worked on the moving average EMA or SMA models before, you would know that we use dot rolling function to do that. And similarly, here also we'll use this dot rolling functionality of pandas data frame. So let me just write roll max is equal to, let's see what is the output. Data close and then close. sorry, it should be data final dot ruling. And if I go 24 hours, which is equivalent to the window that I introduced here, and the min periods is equal to 1. So at one time, it will consider one interval or one candle. That's the idea. And what I'll do is I'll take the maximum of that. So basically what I'm doing is I'm considering this 24 hours of this window, and you are actually checking the maximum value, or I would say the peak in this window. Now before calculating the maximum drawdown in this entire window, let's just calculate the daily drawdown first. So we'll see that the daily drawdown actually changes with time. Actually, I should not use the word daily drawdown, it should be the interval, 5 minutes interval drawdown. So drawdown is equal to basically the data final and then close divided by roll max minus one. So basically I'm using this formula here, the trough value minus peak value divided by peak value. Here also you can see that I'm actually using this. This is not a trough value, this is the daily, the interval close value divided by the maximum value minus one value. Now I'll have to figure out what is, which interval this value was minimum. The interval in which this particular candle is minimum, that will be our maximum drawdown. So it will be the minimum trough and the maximum peak minus one. So you've got this point here, maximum drawdown is, I'll have to just get this minimum value. So again, I'll have to go through this ruling and then window, min periods is equal to 1 dot min. So this is how we can get the maximum drawdown. If I just write it like this, you can see that we have different values of maximum drawdown in front of us. Now it's very difficult to visualize, it's very difficult to analyze this without visualizing, right? So we'll have to use the matplotlib library here. So import matplotlib.pyplot.splt, and then let's plot the dd, which is drawdown, then the maximum drawdown dot plot, and then plt dot show. So you can see that this is the maximum drawdown chart in front of you. So there were some periods in which it went down to more than 8% actually. So can you imagine, like in 24 hours of time period, there were some times when Bitcoin made a loss of more than 8%. And then this is the daily drawdown, the blue line, and this orange is the maximum drawdown. Now, in order to make a trading strategy, this is what we need. We'll have to compare the maximum drawdown or this chart of the buy and hold Bitcoin and our trading strategy. If the chart of our trading strategy looks better than this one, then it means that it is a better strategy in terms of risk. But still, let's work on other parameters before coming to a conclusion. And you know what, I would like to know your opinion here, because like there are people who are who keep value at risk as better measure, and there are people who keep maximum drawdown as a better measure. I've covered both of this video now. You can watch my value at risk videos on like calculating the parametric value at risk or through Monte Carlo simulation, etc. But I would need your opinion. What do you think, like which analysis is a better analysis, value at risk or maximum drawdown? Just mention in the comment box with a valid reason, and I'll feature some of top three comments in my next video. And I'm very, very much interested like how my viewers think about the risk analysis. Also, I share very similar content on other social media channels as well. And you can just scan to this Instagram and the Telegram to join. I share amazing stuff over there. So just scan this right now and then join those platforms. I'll have a detailed discussion of all these things in on those platforms as well. So let's see what was the worst case scenario actually in this entire 15 days time period. So maximum dot min. So you can see that there was one instance when in the period of 24 hours, there was a loss of more than 8%, which is 8.158%. That's a lot of loss in just 24 hours of period. That's why Bitcoin is considered to be a very volatile security for sure. But this is something that we need to analyze, and there has to be like trading strategy which captures this thing and try to cover this huge negative losses in that strategy. Also, if we check the maximum drawdown and let's see what is the mean, then you can see that the mean is close to 5%. So can you imagine, like the maximum drawdown has a mean of 5%, close to 5%. It's a very, very big number in the Bitcoin. So for sure, directly investing in Bitcoin, like making a buy and hold strategy in Bitcoin, can be a difficult, or I would say it can be a very risky strategy for you. It's better to work on some other strategies, like working on Arun oscillator or engulfing. I'm not saying that these strategies will make more money than Bitcoin, but yeah, if you have some other strategy in order to decrease the volatility and decrease this worst case scenario circumstances, then yeah, that strategy is better strategy in my opinion than just buying and holding Bitcoin. Similarly, just let's take the median as well. So again, like you can see that median is more than 5% of the loss. Let's do one thing. Let's just take everything in a data frame. So period.data frame and then max drawdown, and then put, actually we should do it like this. Columns is equal to drawdown, and then inside this, let's just put this max drawdown. So we've got this data frame of this one. I actually converted into data frame because I wanted to use this describe functionality of Pandas. It gives more detailed information. So if I just go here and just write describe, then you can see that we have everything, the count, which is not required here. And the mean is close to 5%. The standard deviation is close to, I would say more than 2%. That's a lot of, it's a very big number considering this small window. And then the minimum is, as we already seen, it's more than 8%. In 75% of the incidences, the loss was close to 3% or more. In 50% of the incidences, it was close to 5%. In 25% of the incidences, the 25% of the worst incidences, it was more than 6.5%. So yeah, this is the number. These are some of the numbers that you would be interested before picking any particular trading strategy. To cover more detailed risk analysis on this channel, then like this video. And depending on the number of likes, I'll see whether my audience is interested in the risk analysis models or not. Then I'll decide to make a very detailed risk analysis playlist for all of you. So if you want this to happen, then please like this video right now, please. Now the gift to all my lovely subscribers, the gift is that I share my Google Drive access with all my subscribers, and in order to get a free access of my Google Drive, you just need to subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on this access to my Google Drive button. Just follow some steps over there, and then on that Google form, you just need to provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address to give a free access of my Google Drive. And I'll save this code, and there are many more codes that are saved in that Google Drive, including my trading bot, algorithmic trading strategies, etc., etc. So just follow all the steps and get a free access of my Google Drive. If you like my work, you can support me by becoming a Patreon member. You can see that there are different medals over there, and then you can join one of them if you want, and there are different services that I provide on in different medals. And this is how you'll be supporting me, financial programming with Ritvik, and this money will be used for very good purposes, because I'm actually planning to buy some APIs, finance APIs, so that I can use them in my next videos and make a really good trading bot and do other things with that. So that would be amazing if you join this thing and put a small contribution for financial programming with Ritvik. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you can see how I created this Bitcoin day trading bot using engulfing strategy, and over there you can see how I backtested this strategy using many parameters. If you like my work, you can support me by clicking on the link below, Patreon link, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you so much.